change your heart, change your life, change the planet.
Hey everybody, I'm about to go to bed, but I wanted to record this before I do, because tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. I'm about to have 2 or possibly 3 more teeth pulled. My dental drama continues. The 4 that I had pulled to have my front bridge put in, that was just the beginning. Now we're doing some more work, I'll just have to roll with it. When I had these guys taken out in 2014, that was pretty scary. But as I've learned with all of the challenges in my life, you eventually adapt, you get used to it, you work with it, you move on. And eventually you forget that it ever happened. So I'm doing my best just to be present, not only to what I'm going through. There's been a lot of pain for the past month or more. It's been keeping me up at night throbbing. So I'm learning how to work through pain. I'm learning how to deal with more teeth being taken out and feeling like I'm old and vulnerable and headed towards my grave. But also it's giving me an opportunity to accept, work with, and move on and know that I've been through things like this before. And it's okay. It's all going to be okay. So that's the message that I want to impart to you tonight. That tomorrow morning something potentially very scary is going to happen, but it's okay. It's all good. It's happening. Can't stop it from happening, so I'm going to work with it. I'm going to embrace it and make the best of the situation and be really gentle with myself and what I feel, whatever comes up. All right? I will check in with you tomorrow after I become toothless. Love you guys. See ya. I'm home and I have 2 fewer teeth than I did this morning. This side of my face is totally paralyzed from the lidocaine, and it was an interesting experience. And when I can speak better, I will tell you all about it.
Dinner. Green chard.
Hey everybody, it's the day after my surgery now, where I had my 2 back molars removed. And I'm out mowing in the blueberry orchard. I don't know if you can see any of the berries. Here, let's give you a closer look. We were having a pretty decent season, but then we had a bear come in and do some major damage to a lot of the bushes, so I'm not sure what kind of crop we're gonna get. That's a bummer. Anyway, back to these guys. This is something that I've been dealing with now for quite a few years. My dental hygiene at this point is beyond exceptional, but when you break through the enamel and get into the dentin, which is what happened a couple years ago, your teeth are going to erode. Our body does not have the ability to remineralize dentin, which is the softer tissue underneath the enamel, which is the hard coating of the teeth, the white part. So if you have erosion that gets through the enamel into the dentin and you don't get a filling, it's only a matter of time before you lose the tooth. So had I dealt with these and got fillings when I had the other dental issues, I probably wouldn't have had to have them pulled, but I didn't. I couldn't afford it at the time, so I had to wait. And I was putting it off and putting it off, and they kept getting worse. So now I'm 2 more teeth in the hole. And because they're my molars, I've lost a lot of my chewing surface. So I may have to get implants so that I can chew again, because even salad without molars is difficult to chew. And this has been a pretty traumatic experience for me for the past few years, not just yesterday and leading up to it. But teeth are a part of you. This is my body. This is me. It's not just this that's me, or this that's me, or my lips, whatever. It's all of me is me. And to lose an essential part of who you are, especially a part that allows you to chew and even form sounds in your mouth, my speech is not the same ever since I've had this guy put in. I talk differently. it's hard for me to make the same kind of sounds. I really can't whistle anymore. Anyways, changed me. And going in yesterday, knowing that I was going to have two more teeth pulled, really put me into a state of humility. Hey, B. A big part of what I do, or what I'm about, I should say, is learning as much as I can, trying to grow as much as I can, trying to get as strong as I can, as fast as I can, but at the same time, not thinking that that makes me better. There's a tendency in the mind, all minds, to take your accomplishments, to take your knowledge, and to pile it up and stand on top of it and look down on other people. And I don't want to do that. And being an insecure person, that is something that I have done in the past. Not because I actually felt better than other people, but because I was scared of them, so I wanted them to esteem me higher so that they wouldn't hurt me, they wouldn't threaten me, or they would want to hang out with me. But even that is not a great strategy for living. So now it's an intentional practice to humble myself, to put myself in situations where I cannot predict or control the outcome, and there's a high probability that it won't go the way that I want. And if I know that going in, it causes me to do the work in a way that I wouldn't otherwise. So if you create this gigantic stretch goal of making a comeback as an athlete and winning a medal at a national championship, that's kind of crazy. The chances of it happening are pretty slim, and you better do the work, especially if you tell people you're going to do it, or at least attempt to do it. So that's what this past year has been like for me, making a comeback several times in the past 9 months, dealing with injury, dealing with illness, and now dealing with this. And each time something like this happens, it grounds me and gets me to look at the world in a very different way, and gets me to look at other people in a very different way, in a more compassionate way. And that is the main focus of all the research that I do, not to be smarter, but so that I can understand how things work, so that I can be more compassionate, so that I don't jump to conclusions thinking I know everything. But instead, I can say, wow, this is a really complex situation, and I know that person's feeling something that's really challenging, and let's try to get to the bottom of it. Let me help them rather than immediately condemning them as being a certain type of person. Maybe there's hope. Maybe there's possibility for growth. I've grown and changed enormously. So if that can happen with me, with this thing up here that's pretty problematic, then I know it can be a possibility for others as well. So, yeah. So even making this video is not easy for me. I don't feel excited about anything right now. I'm sipping smoothies very gently. Everything I eat is blended to death. And it'll be that way for probably at least another week. And even eating the blueberries, I want to be chewing on these guys right now, but I can't. It's hard to keep food out of two spots in your mouth. And I'm like trying to chew on one side, and they manage to get over there, and I'm not even supposed to use a toothbrush or rinse or do anything over there. So I can't even bask in this blue glory. Oh, and one of the things I wanted to mention was yesterday when I was in the chair, I'm a naturally fearful person. I get it from my mom's side, and both my sisters are very similar. We're all very easy to startle. We've got a very low threshold for fear. So a lot of the work that I have been doing on myself personally is to help me deal with situations that are scary. And being in a doctor's chair or a dentist chair is profoundly scary for me, so I've come up with all kinds of ways to make that experience easier. And yesterday, as I was sitting there, I took it upon myself to create some form of control, or experience some form of control in the situation, so it didn't feel like it was totally out of my hands and that I was just a victim that had no choice in the matter. So one of the things that I did inside my head with my inside voice was to say, I'm choosing to be here. This is my choice. Nobody forced me to be here. I'm choosing it. And I'm choosing to have these teeth taken out. And that's scary, and I'm going to be different after that, but it's my choice. And this is going to be potentially painful. I'm choosing that as well. I'm choosing this discomfort. In fact, I choose discomfort every day when I run. Every time I do a hard workout or run up a mountain, it hurts a lot. And I choose that. I'm willing to go there. So let's take the pain I'm going to experience today, or today, dealing with the after effects, and equate that to a workout. Like, I'm choosing to do this. I'm choosing to grow by putting myself into this painful experience. And now I'm not going to be growing new teeth, but I am able to move on now. These guys have been keeping me from sleeping. They've been hurting so much at night. And one of the nerves was just wide open, exposed, and trying to brush my teeth or anything was just brutal. So now I can start getting some sleep. Now I can move beyond that constant pain I was experiencing for the past few months. But I learned a lot in the midst of that pain. I learned gentleness in the midst of pain. I learned a lot of new self-talk methods in the midst of that pain. So when I got into the dentist chair, not only did I exercise a little bit of self-control, or what psychologists call, I created an internal locus of control. A little bit. Can't control everything, but let me control just a little so I don't feel like it's completely out of my hands and I'm helpless. And then I was very enthusiastic by choice with the dentist, or oral surgeon, I should say, and the assistants. And it was really interesting. He got the needle, and because he had to numb the bottom and the top, and he said, okay, I'm gonna put a needle into your palate, and this one's gonna be the worst one. This one's really gonna hurt. But I said to myself, it's gonna feel like the 10th rep of doing some squats with a really heavy weight. I know that pain, it's just pain. I've been there. 10th rep, yeah, that hurts, but I can deal with it. Okay, so here we go, 10th rep. Put it in. That was probably only rep 5. That didn't hurt that much at all. Okay, good. If that's the worst thing that can happen, if that's the most pain I'm going to experience today, perfect. We're done. We're through it. Woo! And then he started putting shots over up into here. And when he did, he hit a nerve, and I forget the name of the nerve that he hit, but it went from here all the way up to the top of my head. When he hit that nerve, there was an explosion of the most intense searing pain I've ever experienced in my life. It felt like somebody was literally taking a blowtorch to the entire side of my head and just searing off the skin. It was beyond excruciating. And from here to the top of my head, every part, my ear, the side of my lip, my nose, my eye, I lost my vision. It was beyond intense. And I've got a needle in my mouth, so I can't jerk quickly or do anything. And the moment he hit that nerve, I let out a sound. I went, oh! I didn't scream, but it was like, oh! And I gripped the sides of the chair, and he kept going. He didn't take it out. It kept going, and he kept injecting. And the more he injected, the more intense the pain got, and the further it traveled. And this went on for 6 seconds, getting worse and worse and worse as it went. And you might say, how much work can you do on yourself in 6 seconds? But when you're in that kind of pain, 6 seconds feels like 6 years. Everything is laser sharp focus on that experience. And my eyes were closed, and all I could imagine was that this is what it's like to be burned. This is what it's like to be in a fire and your flesh being torn off. I'm experiencing that right now. And I won't tell you that the pain didn't bother me, because it did. It really bothered me a lot. But I got through it. I breathed, and I was curious about it. I noticed it. I even saw it with a color. It was yellow, and I could see it shooting around, and I imagined my face glowing with this yellow, like streaks, like lightning bolts going through it. And maybe that decreased the pain a little bit, but it was still beyond intense. But the real work took place right after that moment ended, because I had a choice. I could make the rest of this experience fearful. I could make every other needle shot that he's going to do, because he's got to do my lower jaw too. And I've had experiences where the dentist hit a nerve and it felt like somebody was putting a knife through my tongue and slitting it in half. So maybe that's coming next. I could make this a horrific experience in my mind. But the moment he pulled that needle out, I let out a little laugh and a smile, and I said with my mouth propped open, "That really hurt." And I giggled a little bit. And that was a choice. I didn't want to associate the rest of this experience with pain, with agony. I wanted to quickly wipe that from the plate. I didn't want that residue to stick to me. So I made a comment out loud with a little bit of laughter, and then I went back in again and I said, "I'm choosing to be here." And you did it. You survived. Yeah, that hurt, but guess what? It's not hurting anymore. It's done. It's over. You made it through. So as bad as it's ever going to be, you're going to make through it. You just did. So it's okay. And let's not anticipate what the needle's going to do. Let's not create this image of this intense burning experience again when he starts doing more shots. Let's just relax into it and let it be what it is. Let's not try to predict it. Let's not make a story about it. Let's just be here, because I want to be here. I want this procedure done. And I'm not in a rush. I'm going to let it take its time. So then he did the lower jaw and he didn't hit any nerves, but they came back 10 minutes later and said, "Okay, you should be numbed up." And I'm like, "Actually, I can feel everything. The bottom isn't numb." And the top was totally numb. In fact, my vision still didn't work. I couldn't focus this eye. And my ear was numb. The top of my head was numb. I mean, I really got smoked by hitting that nerve, but the bottom not numb. So he's like, "Oh, okay." So they gave me more. Came back a few minutes later, still not numb. He had to give me more. So I had to go through 3 series of shots on the bottom, but totally cool. Just calm, not attaching one moment to the next, not attaching what happened up here with what's about to happen down here. Totally separate. Totally unrelated. They have nothing to do with each other. They're distinct moments. And the 3 rounds of shots kind of bruised the muscle, so I'm really sore in here today. And I felt like a stroke victim after it was all said and done. This side of my face was really droopy. But I made it through. And when they were pulling the teeth out, there was a woman holding my head steady, because a molar is not easy to get out because they have 4 roots that kind of spread and they often break your jawbone when pulling out molars. So I had to get a bone graft in the top one because they did some damage to my jawbone. The bottom one came out okay, but he really had to crank on it. So you've got a guy putting his entire body weight in your mouth and you can hear it. You can hear the jawbone, you can hear the tooth, and you hear snapping and crackling, and it's kind of intense, and it's your face, it's your body, it's my tooth, it didn't want to go. So, just sharing what's going on and how I deal with it. And now I'm dealing with kind of a lethargy. Whoa, I'm going to fall into a blueberry tree. This experience has been pretty tough on me in a number of different ways, and I'm still getting myself into action, even though I don't feel like doing much. I've slept half the day already, but this is my second time outside mowing a blueberry orchard, and I'm just going to keep myself going little by little without a whole lot of expectation and without big goals at the moment. When I'm not feeling great, when I'm in that state of humility, when I'm in a state of kind of depression, I guess you would call it. Most people would probably call this a severe depression, but for me, I'm so used to it and I know how to work with it. So it's okay, but I feel it, like there's no interest to do anything. So I just have to put myself in motion and remember that this blueberry orchard is here, or remember that I've got a great audiobook to listen to, and keep myself engaged in the process in life. And this will pass. Just like that pain came and went, what I'm going through right now will come and go, and then I'll get my energy back and I'll be more excited and enthusiastic, and I'll tackle bigger things. But right now, I'm just going to be really gentle and get through this. And yeah, so there's a little update. And hopefully I don't have to lose many more teeth. I have another one out there that's going to come out sometime in the next few months. And then I'll have to get another implant. So, not a lot of fun, but this is my journey. So let's try to make the best of it. Let's create some learning here. And let's keep a smile on our faces, even in the midst of suffering, or at least immediately after. All right. I love you guys, and I hope you're doing well. And whatever you're facing right now, whatever you're challenged by, you can get through it. And when you do, smile and say, this new moment is different than what I just went through. And this new moment is full of possibilities. And this new moment is worth investigating. All right, see you guys. I wanted to talk about my favorite subject right now, my teeth. That's right, I want to talk about my teeth. Because some of you are uncomfortable that I'm not wearing my prosthetic denture while making videos. And I don't want to make anybody wrong or scold anybody. I just want to talk about that. Okay? So let's do it. Ready? Here we go.